Hello, I am Dr. Anesthesia. I would like to ask you a question. Is local anesthesia a strategy for reducing surgical site infections? You don't know? Never mind. I will tell you. This same question was asked by Drs. Lee J.S., Hyung I., Kubis J.J., Mac P.S.H., Hutton M., Campbell D.A. Jr., and Engels B.M.J. from the Department of Surgery, University of Michigan Medical School. As you probably know, surgical site infections, SIS, contribute to increased morbidity, mortality, and hospitalization costs. A previously unidentified factor that may reduce SIS is the use of local anesthesia. The objective of this study was to determine if the use of local anesthesia is independently associated with a lower incidence of SIS compared to non-local anesthesia, using the American College of Surgeons National Surgical Quality Improvement Program database, 2005 to 2007. They identified all patients undergoing surgical procedures that could be performed using local or general anesthesia, depending on the preference of the surgeon. Logistic regression was used to identify factors independently associated with the use of local anesthesia. Propensity matching was then used to match local and non-local anesthesia cases while controlling for patient and operative characteristics. Of 111,683 patients, 1928 underwent local anesthesia. And in 109,755 cases, the patients were given general anesthesia where a local anesthetic potentially could have used. In the unmatched analysis, patients with local anesthesia had a significantly lower incidence of SIS than patients with non-local anesthesia. 0.7 versus 1.4, p equals 0.013. Similarly, after propensity matching, the incidence of SIS in patients given local anesthesia was significantly lower than for that of patients given non-local anesthesia. 0.8 versus 1.4, p equals 0.043. So, now you know the answer. Use of local anesthesia is independently associated with a lower incidence of SIS. It may provide a safe, simple approach to reducing the number of SIS. Thank you. And keep updated.